Welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna redo a video that I have for my Bioshank or Osobuco. So we're gonna redo the video, and this time I'm gonna be able to explain it to you guys in English because they request me a lot of people, you know, to do the video but in English, so that way they can understand and they can follow the recipe. This is a classic version of the osobuco or a shank. You can be either pork, beef, any shank. Is basically a cut from the beef, the caro, the beef. So you can use any shank. And we're gonna need as many pieces as you need. So what I'm gonna do with these ones, I'm gonna tie them out. So first you're gonna dry up your meat with a towel, paper towel, and remove the excess of, you know, blood or anything that you have, so that way when we sear it, you know, it doesn't splash that much. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna need a twine. This is a butcher's twine, and as much as you need, you know, but this is just a little piece that we're gonna use. And we're gonna tie it from here, so that way when you cook it, you know, it doesn't break apart, because you can see these pieces, it's gonna fall out apart. So this is, when you tie it, it's gonna help us to, you know, keep the meat together in the same place, in, you know, like that. And then just tie it and cut it, just like that, okay? And then same thing, you're just gonna pat it dry, remove the excess of blood. And then I'm gonna wash my hands, come back, and tell you the next ingredients. So after you have your meat already, you know, tied down all around, so we're gonna season it with salt, pepper to taste. So just sprinkle some salt around the steaks or the shanks, all around. And like I say, you know, you can use any kind of shank. You can do pork shanks, you can do beef shanks, lamb, anything. It doesn't have to be just beef. You can also do the wild boar also. So salt, pepper to taste around. And then we're gonna lightly dust it with flour. And in the meantime, you're gonna have your pan already preheating, either saute pan or your fryer, either or whatever it works. So now we're just gonna flour it like this. So lightly flour it all around and remove the excess of flour. We don't want a lot of flour, it's just to help us to sear our meat. And just like that, all the pieces. So when I'm done with this, we're gonna come back and start searing. So after you have your pan already hot, now you're gonna add oil, about half a cup, and we're gonna start searing our meat. And we're gonna cook it for about 2 minutes on each side, and then we're gonna come back and do the next step. All right, so after you have your meat already seared, so you're just gonna take it out of the pan. And what we're gonna do next, we're gonna remove some of the excess of the fat or the oil. Because now we're gonna saute our vegetables. So you don't want, you know, a lot of fat. And also we're gonna need a half a cup of red wine. You can do you red wine, white wine, or no wine at all. It's gonna be up to you. Also, half a cup of tomato paste or tomato sauce or hot tomatoes, or plum tomatoes, crush it. Whatever you wanna do, also is fine. And 2 cups of water, the bay leaves, the peppercorn, and the cloves. And also the fresh herbs. So now we're gonna start making our sauce. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna start with the garlic, some of the oil, and then we're just gonna get a little golden brown color on the garlic and the onion. And then we're gonna cook this for about 2 minutes. And also, we're gonna come back when this is done and, you know, start doing the rest of the ingredients. Now you're gonna add your herbs, aromatic. So rosemary, thyme, sage. It could be dry or fresh. So like this, a clove, a peppercorn. And then we're just gonna get some flavor out of it about 2 minutes, and then we're gonna come back, add the tomato and the wine. Right. So now you add your tomato paste or the tomato sauce, long tomatoes, whole tomatoes, any kind of tomato. And also we're gonna add some salt to taste. And we have just a fresh black pepper. So what we're gonna do, we're just gonna caramelize or get some of the tomato paste for here, you know, to cook a little bit. And this dish, you know, it's a classic dish that it takes time to do. It doesn't cook in 5 minutes, you know, it doesn't cook in a half an hour. This meal takes about 3 to 6 hours in the oven, depending, you know, how you want it cooked. But in the restaurant, you know, we go from 3 to 4 up to 6 hours if we cook it in a low heat, you know, like 275 for 6 hours, depending. So if you're looking for a fast dish, this is not for you. This is a dish that you make, let it break, let it cook, and forget about it, you know, 3 hours, come back, and your dinner is ready. So now, at this time, we're gonna deglaze with the red wine or water, white wine, whatever you want to do, it's up to you, it's your choice. And also depending on the wine, also whatever you like, you know, whatever you drink in the night, you can add it. So we're gonna cook our wine, let it reduce, and then we're gonna come back, add the water, and start baking or braising. So what I did, you know, I placed my shanks on the pan, and now we're gonna add the vegetables. And like you see, you know, my wine is still there, it's kind of thick. I didn't put my water here because we're gonna add it to our pan. So just like that. And then we're gonna add the water. And like I said before, you know, this meal, this dish, is not gonna cook in half an hour. So if you have time, then, you know, you cook this meal in advance. Can cook it the day before if you want, or if let's say you go to work and it's gonna take you about 5 to 6 hours to come back home, put your oven at 200 175, let it cook in a slow heat, and then by the time you get home, you know, it's gonna be nice and soft like butter. So, or if you have time, you know, let's say that you want to, you have a meat and you have enough time right now to do, you know, like a lump braising, then this dish is for you. Now we're just gonna add the water. And you can cover it with a plastic film, commercial plastic film, not just the saran wrap that you use regularly at home. Or just wax paper on the bottom, you know, foil, whatever you wanna do is fine. It's gonna be up to you. So what I did in my previous video, I put my saran wrap or plastic film, that is a commercial grade restaurant, you know, and cover it like this all around, and then put my foil and let it cook for 3 hours at 375. So like I said, with the plastic film, you can put it on or you can leave it out. It's gonna be up to you. Whatever you wanna do is fine. You don't have to do it. So now I'm just gonna put my foil. I'm gonna come back because I don't wanna make too much noise with the foil. And then we're just gonna put them in the oven. I have my oven preheated 375 for, we're gonna cook it for 3 hours and then come back, check it and serve it. 3 hours, now we're gonna take it out. And just be careful when you try to wrap it. Remember that it's been close tight, so you're gonna have a steam coming out. So make sure you take it like this and go around. So first lay it out. And as you can see, plastic is still here, okay? So Now, like I say, if you want to put it on, you can put it on. If you don't want to, don't risk it. That's fine. It's gonna be up to you. So, as you can see, watch. It's not on the foot, it's on the foil, okay? So now, we're gonna take it out and serve it. You can let it rest a little bit if you like. And this is why we tie up our osobuco, so that way it doesn't break up pieces when it's in the on the plate. See, like butter, 3 hours. So I have a risotto in the back, risotto alla milanese. So now we're gonna do it like the real Italian style. Risotto milanese with osobuco and the gremolat for our osobuco. So I'm gonna come back and plate it. So in the meantime that you have your osobuco resting, now what I did, I removed my drippings. So this is gonna become my sauce. And also, when I was in Italy, you know, we used to put the ladle on the ice to make it cold. So when you get contact with the fat, it's just gonna coagulate. Or you can also just add it to the here, and you're gonna see all the fat coagulating, and it's gonna be way easy to remove it. So as soon as we got all the fat out, we're gonna come back, reduce our sauce, and serve it. So as soon as you see your sauce ready, and if you see there's a little runny, what we do, we go to the, you know, to the old school method. You can do your roux on the side, or you can make this one, the bourmenier. And just equal parts flour and butter, and then you just grab as you need. Or you can always make a slurry with cornstarch and water, but you know, just an old school trick. Just bring it to boil. It's gonna make my salsa thick, and just cook it like for 5 minutes, and this is ready. So after we have our risotto, I have my risotto here, and I got it in the bottom of my plate. So I have a video on how to make the risotto alla milanese. Also, I have my video on how to make the gremolat. This one we can use it for our meat. You can use it for fish, for chicken, anything you want. I got those two videos separately, so that way you can enjoy it and see them. Now you're gonna just pour your sauce all around. This is a very classic dish from southern France. So Milano, Bergamo, all Italy, north side of Italy. Basically all the north side, you know, winter, fall, heavy, steady meal. And hopefully you guys like this video on how to do the osobuco. And like I said before, you know, I make my video the first time, but I didn't do it the right way. You know, I just make it up and do whatever I want. But it goes with the risotto or polenta or pasta, your choice. And then the gremolat, same thing, and the sauce. So hopefully you guys like this video on how to prepare the osobuco Italian style. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, follow me on Chef Alex Perez on Facebook, Chef Alex Perez on YouTube. And to finish this dish, just a little extra olive oil, and voila, viva la Italia, viva la France, and enjoy guys, thank you. Now I'm gonna be able to drink it with some red wine. Last time I didn't have it either, so enjoy, thank you.